Hey guys, this is Marty. So I recently came upon a new art genre that I didn't know before. It's called Brutalism, and it was developed in Europe after World War II. It's kind of an art style that you either love or you hate. The visual style of Brutalism, I would say, is pretty dystopian. It's rough and raw. As a matter of fact, Brutalism is derived from a French word, brut, which is translated into raw, which is pretty much what Brutalism is. It's raw. I created this Brutalist poster design for us to recreate. I did provide this eyeball, I think is shocking, which again is a Brutalist characteristic. So the first step that we'll do is convert the eyeball into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and allow us to replace it with a different image without having to redo the effects. So to do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Before we proceed with the filters, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard or click this icon. If they're reversed, click this curved double arrow. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Reticulation. The density is 2, the foreground level is 22, and the background level is 11. To save some space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the Smart Filter. We'll make two copies of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In it, we'll create a thick diagonal black line. Open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. Pick a hard, round point. Make it size 25 pixels. Its opacity is 100%. Place your cursor outside the document, approximately here, click, and release. Place your cursor below the document, approximately here, and shift-click it to make a black diagonal line 25 pixels thick. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Edit, Transform, and flip horizontal. Press V on your keyboard to open the Move tool, and at the top, make sure Auto Select is not checked. This will prevent other layers from becoming active when you click on your document. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag the second diagonal line to approximately here. Make the line below it active, and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it to the left until its top is touching the corner of the document. Hide the top eye layer and make the middle eye layer active. We're going to invert this layer but confine it to the right side of this diagonal line. To do this, Ctrl or Command click the top layer to select the shape of the line. Press Q on your keyboard to convert the selection into a quick mask. Open your Paint Bucket tool, and at the top, make sure Contiguous is checked. This ensures that it'll fill or delete only the pixels that are directly attached to the ones of the same color. I'll explain more in a moment. Click the Paint Bucket tool anywhere on the Quick Mask to the left of the line to delete that section of the Quick Mask. If Contiguous wasn't checked, it would have deleted the Quick Mask to the right of the line as well. Press Q to revert the quick mask back into a selection. We'll make an inverted layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. To do this, Alt or Option click the layer mask icon. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Invert. Presently, our entire eye image is inverted. To restrict or clip it to affect just the white area of the layer mask, hover your cursor between the two layers and press and hold Alt or Option. When your cursor changes into a clipping mask icon, click it. Another way to clip it is to go to Layer and create clipping mask. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Levels. We'll clip this as well so it'll just affect that same area confined by the layer mask. make the input black level 100 and the output white level 135. Make the top eye layer visible and active. Control or Command click the lower diagonal line to select its shape. We'll repeat the same steps as before. First, convert it into a quick mask. With your paint bucket tool still active, click anywhere on the quick mask to delete that area. Revert it back into a selection and make an inverted layer mask next to the top eye layer. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Clip it to the top eye layer. Check Colorize. Make the hue 11 and the saturation 100. To save more space in the Layers panel, let's place all the layers that comprise the eye image into a folder. Shift-click the bottom layer to make it and all the layers between it and the top eye layer active. Press Ctrl or Command-G. Let's name it Eye. Next, we'll add the text to our poster. Make the bottom line active and make a new layer above it. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. I'm picking a font called Bebas New Regular. If you'd like to use it as well, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. Click the color box to open the color picker. Pick a color for your text. I'll pick a rich, bright red, which is often used in brutalist designs. Click on your document. I'll make its size 353 points. However, feel free to make it whatever size you like based on the font you pick and the number of characters in your text. I'll make its aliasing smooth and left alignment. Type out your text. To adjust the space between your lines of text, known as leading, double-click the large T of your text layer to highlight all of your text, and at the top, click the character paragraph icon to open the character panel, or you could go to Window and Character. Place your cursor over the leading icon and drag it to the right or left. If you want to adjust the size of any of the characters or lines of text, click on your text to unhighlight them and drag your cursor over those characters or lines you want to resize. At the top, drag the size icon to the right or left. In this example, I want to raise up the top line, so I'll click my text to unhighlight them and drag my cursor over the top line. I'll place my cursor over the baseline shift icon and drag it to the right. Continue to finesse your text sizes until you like the way it looks. If you want to adjust the space between groups of characters, known as tracking, double-click the thumbnail of your text layer to highlight all your text and press and hold Alt or Option plus the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. Open your Move tool and drag your text so the top line is touching the top of your document. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool and drag the lower left corner so the bottom of your text touches the bottom of your document. Then press Enter or Return. Lastly, we'll reposition the text to the right of this diagonal line. But before we do, let's close the character paragraph panels. Make a copy of the text layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Make the bottom text layer active and open the I folder. Scroll down and place your cursor over the bottom layer mask. Press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the layer mask up next to the bottom text layer and release. We'll drag a copy of this layer mask to the top text layer by again pressing and holding Alt or Option as we drag it up and release. Notice our text to the left of the diagonal line disappeared. That's because the black section of the layer mask is masking it out. Always remember this. In layer masks, white reveals and black conceals. To reveal back our text, we'll invert the top layer mask. To do this, make the top layer mask active and press Ctrl or Command I. Click the chain link icon on the bottom text layer to unlink the layer and the layer mask. This allows us to resize and reposition either of them independently of the other. Click the large T to make the text active. Make sure your Move tool is active, and press and hold Shift and any of the arrow keys on your keyboard to move the text up, down, or sideways 10 pixels at a time. To move it 1 pixel at a time, don't press the Shift key. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.